over for millions of years at least now, because it was a drop into. There are nights in which millions of birds, literally millions of birds, fly in, and as dawn breaks, a few thousand of them drop down to say it's time for me to eat right here.
So if the United States were all one big, wonderful forest, you would have these birds all scattered. But what happens when they are on the northeast coast? And here you have this urban mess of buildings and no green showing, and don't see a little patch of green from way up there? That's Central Park. And they'll come in.
Scientists call it the Central Park. It's well understood now that all the major cities, the biggest parks, are places that really do concentrate humanity. And they don't concentrate there by accident. They concentrate there because they are choosing to land in that spot, because they see and know that that's going to produce what they need. Most of the birds we see as migrants are coming from the tropics, one part of the other tropics. The songbirds largely are coming from Mexico, Guatemala, Costa Rica, from South America in some cases, the shorebirds from all over Argentina. Here comes 9 o'clock at night, moving across the country, and all that blue is bird imagery. This is a radar map that shows, it shows a storm. The main thing is it's showing a continent full of birds passing overhead all night long, beginning around 9 p.m. The Central Park. Okay, there's a huge corridor of birds right up in there because they're migrating along the coast, heading up on into the Canadian provinces to breed.
The goal of all these migrants, the whole reason they leave the tropics in the first place, is to breed and raise young where they can find an abundant food supply. And for a